ganyan sila, ano sila sa production. Ganyan yan. Magagaling.
Oo, producer. Kaya dami.
Producer yan. Oo.
Diba? Producer. Ano producer?
Produce.
Ano yung pinaproduce? Orange juice.
Orange juice.
Apple juice.
Oo, basta nag-juice.
Hello, hi, mabuhay! It's your Filipina diva, Marina Summers, and I'm back for a mother talking show. Welcome to The Stopover, the unofficial, unauthorized, and ultimately unbothered recap show of Drag Race Philippines. I am pretty sure that everyone is asking, begging, and dying for more Drag Race Philippines Season 2 content. So, you came to the right place because I'm gonna give it to you. Oh, well, look, I could have. Plus, I won't be alone because every Beyonce needs her Michelle. So I will be joined by different fabulous drag queens from across the Drag Race multiverse here at The Stopover. And to start off the season with episode 1 of Drag Race Philippines Season 2, nag-invite kami ng pinakamaganda, pinakapasabog, pinakabalingkinitan, pinakamabait, pinakamatalino, pinakasalahat ng pinaka. Unfortunately, she couldn't make it today, so we have Lady Morgana instead.
Pala! Wala silang choice.
Correct!
Maraming salamat, Marina, for having me here. Ah, English!
Oh, English!
English!
Okay, I have a question. How have you been? Lagi ko sinasabi si Morgana ang true definition ng All-Stars Glow Up.
Ako, masaya at saka ano, lahat, ano, parang roller coaster ride and blessed.
Pani roller coaster?
Yung mga, woo! Yes!
Yeah,
woo! Yes. Tapos ano, masaya at saka ano, fulfilled yung dream ko na aside from Rue Girl na ako, yung mga projects, dumadami, yes. Lahat ng mga ano viewing parties, mm-hmm. na ano ko na naikot ko na lahat. From Luzon, Visayas, Mindanao, na ano ko na napuntahan ko ng mga shows dahil lang sa Drag Race Philippines. Diba? Ang saya lang. Ganon.
And you are also the face of Davao Drag now,
yes.
Diba? You represented Davao so well. Mm-hmm. Meron ka ng mga pa-billboard, meron ka ng pa-advertisement, brand ambassadorships. Are you excited to see the next roster of queens dominating this season?
So ako lang. Buhay nila yan. Ayun, masaya, masaya. Excited ako kung ano ang double the drama.
Correct.
Double the fun, double the excitement.
By far, without watching the episode, sino yung mga tumatak sa utak mo?
Ako, yung promo pa lang, yung trailer pa lang nila, ang tumatak ko tatlo lang eh.
Mm-hmm.
Is Arizona, mm-hmm. Bernie, mm-hmm. and of course, Jade So.
Mm-hmm.
Silang tatlo yung talaga ano ko.
Yeah. And now, let's jump right into it. The episode starts and they reveal a very, very big workroom. Well, let's go over the queens this season. They started walking into the workroom. I know they are very thrilled, mm-hmm. kinakabahan, excited, nervous. Uh-huh. But the first queen to walk the workroom for Drag Race Philippines Season 2 is Arizona Brandy.
Uh-huh.
At ang sabi niya, ito ang tunay na shot puno habang naka-dextro siya. No, sis, parang ikaw yung may kailangan ng dextros.
Parang ako kailangan ng dextros na ano. Alam mo, ang saya, ang ganda ng ano pag-entrance ni Arizona. Mm. Yung siya talaga yung first talaga na papasok.
What do you think about her look naman?
Malinis.
Mm-mm.
Malinis. Yung mukha lang hindi. Chai! Chai lang!
And then we see the next queen to walk in the workroom, Matilda.
Matilda, handa na ba kayo? Mm-hmm. Oh, di ba? Anak lang ni Corina Sanchez. Bonggang-bongga. Catchy? Kasi nandun yung ano yung da. Kasi mm-hmm. sa Matilda, mm-hmm. Handa na ba kayo? Ganda yung ano niya, pag-entrance niya, parang ano lang siya, sweet girl.
Mm-hmm. Very reserved.
Reserved. Pero tingnan natin kung mm-hmm. for the follow episodes kung sweet girl ba siya.
Correct. For me, I think it's a good entrance look. I think it's clean. The colors I love. It's not muted. It's not so muted. It's not so screaming. So mm-hmm. it's just very, you know, represents her very feminine,
yeah.
very malambot. I just wish there's a little bit more cinch in the middle because there's a lot of things going on. And a cinch would really, you know, pull everything together and have a focal point.
Yeah.
So moving on, we have Tiny Deluxe.
Ay!
What do you think of her entrance?
Yes. Ang ano niya, yung yung catchphrase na, yung lines niya,
chubby ah.
Ano kasi yan sa Twitter?
Kaya, oo, si ano,
Oo. Kaya pang lima siya. Ay, ganun.
Yes. Oo. Okay, bago pa tayo patumbahin. What do you think? What do you think of her look?
Ay! Ngayon.
She's referencing to Dora the Explorer.
Ano lang sana, yung boots niya na puti, sana naging violet na lang.
Bakit?
Magbuka siyang sapin sa pin. Charos na! Ano ba? Tsaka dapat, sa likod niya, dapat may unggoy.
Oo.
Kulang kasi, sa bagay, nasa US naman si Corazon. Ah! Amagutin! Si Corazon!
I kind of live with the look. I love it. I love how clean it is.
Mm-hmm.
But as a first-time viewer of Tiny Deluxe, I'm not sure how this particular concept and look represents her drag. Baka pinaperform niya na tong Dora the Explorer sa mga club. So we really want to see it even further kung why
Dora.
This entrance look represents her. But I think she's funny. She's, you know, energetic.
Energetic. So yung watch out pala natin.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then the next queen to enter the workroom is a queen from Cebu, Nicole Pardo.
Ah! Bisaya!
Bisaya!
Ginoo ko! Ganon. Happy na
yes.
Meron na tayong representative from
Cebu.
Cebu!
The Queen of the South.
The Queen of the South. Mm-hmm. Tapos, ayan si Nicole Pardo pagpasok. Ayun lang, yung buhok. Ganon. Mm-hmm. Yung nakita ko yung buhok lang talaga. Sana siya. Yung parang nakaset na ano ba, cobra ba or something.
Yep.
Pero yung ano yung entrance line niya na Die Ali Diri, Sabak kay Mami B.
Mm-hmm.
Ay! Yan yung ano kasi, yan yung kanta ng mga taga Cebu.
Yes, yung binubudots nila ganyan.
Binubudots
diba?
Nila ganyan.
Paano?
Die Ali
Diri.
Uy! Ay, makikita pala. Oh, diba? Ganon. So, ayan! Maganda register sa TV si Nicole Pardo.
That's what I wanted to say. Her register on camera is very, very feminine. Mm-hmm. I love it. Tama ka, dapat sana naka-cobra yung hair.
Para makita
kasi
yung mukha.
Para may opening yung face, parang,
ganon.
Ganon, diba?
Kasi, diba, pag once entrance look, that is yung ano eh, yung parang first impression ng mga viewers.
Yes.
Sana ginandahan palalo yung ano niya, yung damit. Para kasi siya nagma-mall show.
Pero kasi yung aesthetic niya is very MILF, very tita, diba? So, I think it represents her drag then and showing her her twins, diba? The next queen to step into the workroom came with a surprise and a little bit of drama. Were you intrigued?
Oo. Naman. Diba? Alam na, nakat-cut ka agad. Pating na. Mukhang pating ka lang. Charas!
What do you think of her overall entrance performance?
Sakto lang. Sakto. Hindi siya nakaka-amaze. Yung parang pag alam mo agad na yung pating palang cut-cut na. Captivating mm-hmm. cut-cut. Tapos yung lines niya na, maganda ba ako sa picture? Alam mo, hindi dapat ako mag-comment yan.
Mm-hmm.
Guess mo si Minty Press nga. Siya nang mag-comment yan. Diyos ko na, ayoko ng mga away pangit. Charas!
Kaya pala wala kang kaaway.
Oo nga, wala akong kaaway. Kaya miss congeniality. Kasi pangit.
I'm not gonna lie, this might be a controversial take, but... Sabihin ko ba? I think she kinda ate that. I honestly really love her entrance performance. I was living for it. It was good TV. The performance was there.
Mm-hmm.
And I appreciate queens who do callbacks with their own selves, sa mga lines nila, sa mga iconic statements nila. But the look though, do you like the look?
Ano combination sa... Naba sa color ano? Wheel ng orange at saka blue? Charos lang! Charos lang!
And then... Next to walk into the workroom is the beautiful, the bodacious Miss Jade.
Maganda. Wala akong masabi dahil.
Yeah, oh. And I loved her entrance line. Mm-hmm. It's raining men. But I think what really sold it for me is her entire entrance look. It represents her claim to be the sexiest, cuntiest, esoteric brat doll. You know, I love it. It's very, you know. it's giving body, sexy, yeah, skin.
Yeah.
And then walang paligoy-ligoy si Mama Pao. They went straight right into the mini challenge. Woo! The first mini challenge of the season where they have to pose for their lives in front of the sexy, the beautiful, the gorgeous, mm-hmm, the titikman of all titikmans. BJ, mm-hmm, Pascual.
Yeah, magkasunod lang kami ng birthday niya.
Yes, and they have to pose with a live tarantula. Would you do it?
Oh, naman.
Would you be scared though?
I know, hindi. Hindi ako scared sa tarantula.
Okay, at this moment, who do you think is doing well and who do you think is struggling?
Doing well, Jade Soul. Not uh-huh, doing well, captivating Katka.
Aha, uh-huh, and we can definitely see that in the camera. Uh-huh. Medyo startle siya. And then back into the workroom, we reveal that the winner of the first ever mini challenge for Drag Race Philippines Season 2 is Matilda!
Yeah.
Do you agree with the winner?
Agree na lang. Mm-hmm. Agree na ako sa ano. Kasi ganda yung pagka-post niya. Parang relax. Deserved.
Yeah, and I love that the tarantula is placed right in her eye. It gives a little bit of mystery. Yeah. A little bit of, you know, edge. But I must say, strong contender din yung picture ni Miss Jade. So congratulations, Matilda, our first ever winner of the mini challenge for Drag Race Philippines Season 2, winning 20,000 pesos!
Yes!
I passed the crown!
Ay, ikaw pala yung una!
At the first ever mini challenge winner, yes, of all queens in Drag Race Philippines, yes, season 1. So right after that, we finally see the queens de-dragging in the workroom. Ah. What were your observations?
Una, Nicole Pardo.
Yes, uh-huh.
Nicole Pardo kaagad.
And what about Nicole Pardo?
Parang siyang classmate ni Gigi Eros.
Bakit?
Parang alam, police sa SPO1,
SPO2. SPO1, SPO2, different generations but same family.
Parang same ano lang, yung pa-debunk.
Right after the mini challenge, it's time to win another challenge, which is the maxi challenge.
Ay!
Mama Pao finally announced that they will be doing, ready for it?
Uh-huh.
The girl group challenge on the first episode.
Ay. Girl! Girl!
Wala! For me, ha, I think it's extra, extra, extra hard for the girls because they just met and they don't know their strengths. They don't know each other pa. They're still getting to know. And it's hard to put up a girl group when you don't know each other.
Ay, yeah. Yun right? Yung challenge.
So that's the challenge for them.
Yun yung double the challenge.
Yes.
Yeah.
And also, on top of that,
take note.
Pop Off Ate was a monumental hit. It was an international hit. So I think they have really big shoes to fill season.
Uh-huh.
And then, Mama Power revealed that they will be judged and mentored by the X Factor breakout artist, Fourth Impact, Irie. Oh,
Almira.
Shit. Almira and Irie.
Mylene.
And they are the twins. Oh no, they're not twins. The Fourth Impact sisters, Almira and Mylene. Yes! When they are doing the recording right off the bat, what are your highlights?
Highlights. Una-una, wala, favorite ko talaga to Jade, so eh, yun yung highlights.
You're very vocal about that.
Yeah.
Yes, we love that.
Ano. Mm-hmm. Tapos, sana naman yung ano, sa akin lang ha, kasi yung representation natin, yung sa season 1, di ba, na nag-write tayo ng lyrics, yung akin, Tagalog, English yung lyrics ko. Sad to say with Nicole Pardo, na sana naman meron siyang, okay naman yung ano, yung shagit, Viva Viva, pero sana meron siyang this half of it is English and half of it is beside the representation of Cebu.
Yeah. For me, yung pinaka-highlight nung recording was Tiny Deluxe.
Yeah, Tiny!
I loved her voice. Okay, during the rehearsals, we see the girls get a little bit spicy and feisty with each other. Kasi sabi ni Nicole Pardo, she feels a little bit disappointed kasi hindi siya pinapakinggan ng the rest of the girls with her suggestions. And on the other hand, Tiny Deluxe and Captivating Kat says that hindi masyadong nagme-make sense yung mga suggestions ni Nicole Pardo. What do you think of that situation?
Ako kasi yung ano, yung dun sa, di ba, way back yung sa ating girl group. Leader si Brigiding, however, binigay sa inyo yung choreography, ikaw, at saka si Turi, nag-share tayo ng thoughts. And a good leader should be a good listener. Mm-hmm. Ang kulang na kasi nila is, wala kasi nagpo-push sino talaga ang leader sa kanila. Lahat sila leader dahil.
Correct. There's too many chefs in the kitchen, kumbaga.
True.
Tama? If you really want to make a girl group, everyone has to work together. Everyone has to listen to each other. Mm-hmm. But then again, it's a competition. So that might be a strategy for the girls to get rid of another competition. And then we move on to the main stage. They reveal a bigger, a bolder, double the stage, double the LED, double the lights.
Yeah.
And then we see Mama Pau. What do you think of Mama Pau's season 2 look?
Ay! 1980s bakla! Mga ganun mga tis-tis na buhok. At pumayat, take po pumayat si Mama Pau.
And then we see our lovely panel, Kalad Karen, Jiggly Caliente, BJ Pascual, and
the Fourth Impact.
The Fourth Impact. Yeah.
Napansin ko ang Jiggly Caliente na pa-virgin lang
virgin
siya.
Virgin
lang siya. Paganyan lang siya. Paganyan lang ang buhok, di ba? Ganyan lang. Ganyan talaga mas strategy pag episode 1 na pa-virgin lang ang judge. Napalapit ng ending na doon na sila paganda ng paganda.
Oh. And then we start straight off the bat for the world premiere of Boogsh.
Boogsh. Pangalan ng grupo nila is Pack Girls.
Pack Girls. By the Pack Girls. Okay, let's go one by one with the performances and the looks. Matilda, what do you think of her?
Performance of Matilda. Yeah, she's a good dancer.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Very dancerous.
I love it.
I love it. I love Matilda's energy. I love the look. She looks clean, sleek. I think throughout the performance, I think it's really hard to open the show and stay, relevant and stay seen until the end.
Yeah, ang hirap talaga.
So I think that's also a challenge for her. But then the judges feel like Matilda's performance was a little bit lacking daw. Dahil nga, sabi ni Karen Karen na hindi niya masyadong nakilala si Matilda dahil lang sinabi niya lang, dancer lang siya.
Dancer. Sino ba si Matilda? Ganun. Yeah.
But I think I kind of disagree with that. I think Matilda definitely was able to establish na, oh, I'm a dancer. That's better than nothing. Right? That's better than nothing. So I think it's still a good first impression for Matilda. And kung nagets ni Kalad Karen na dancer si Matilda, Matilda did the job real well. Okay, Nicole Pardo.
Nicole Pardo.
Yeah, Nicole Pardo.
Yeah, Nicole Pardo. Ayun yung looks. Andun na yung mukha, ang ganda na na-register sa camera yung mukha niya. Sana nang nag-ponytail na lang siya.
Yeah.
Tsaka yung looks niya, parang hindi nag-cohesive sa
the rest of the girls.
The rest of the girls.
For me, I think the lack of commitment to her claim of being a dancer took it out for me. Kasi siya, sinasabi niya choreographer siya, dancer siya. But I didn't see any of that in the performance. So I was kind of expecting something from her, but yeah, that didn't show in the performance. Sayang, missed opportunity to really show that talent of her and to stand out from the rest of the group. And then right after Nicole Pardo, we have Arizona Brandy. What do you think of her performance?
Yung lyrics niya, brand niya talaga yun. Yan, shot pa, ganun. Yep. Ganun, malinaw na pinakilala ni Arizona yung sino siya sa buong mundo.
Yep, I think branding, again, Arizona is very good at branding herself. I think the lyrics were a little bit shallow, but I think Arizona Alakpa is the boom to ring of this group.
Yeah.
Yeah. The look, not really a fan of the look. I think the hair was flat. If it's gonna be flat, we're human. Yeah. If it's gonna be flat, layer it so it don't cover your face. We see in a lot of spots in the performance that her hair is, taking away the glorious face. The judges loved her performance. Think very high energy. Makikita mo talaga na matagal niya nang ginagawa ang pagpa-perform. Yeah. Next is Captivating Katkat. What do we think of her?
Reveal. Diba? Pinakita niya yung this is trance. Mm-hmm. Ito yung trance.
For me, lyrics-wise, not really a fan of. Offbeat. When you're gonna rap, it should be in beat. But hey, if you're talking about 23 years of drag, that is how you fucking do it. And then it's time for another Pinay Trance Power, Miss Jade. So what do we think of her performance?
One sentence. She shows her body.
A lot of that skin
from
love the body.
From front to side to back to the hair.
Love it.
Polish. Super polish.
I think Jade So really did well. I think for me, nasabi niya lahat ng gusto niyang sabihin, na introduce niya yung brand niya, na pakilala niya. I really get what she really represents. Medyo may konting lacking sa performance side, sa choreography. But overall, I think she carried it.
Yeah,
I loved it. And then finally, we have Tiny Deluxe giving us vocals.
The resemblance of Venus Deluxe.
Kaya, yes. Diba? Coded.
Coded.
The House of Deluxe coded.
Yeah.
Right?
Then, kung ano vocals. Anong nanay, yung anak din, magaling.
Yes.
Yung the vocals, the pronunciation, klarong-klaro. Hindi na tayo magbabasa ng lyrics, pero yep, naintindihan na natin yung yes, ano niya. Yung pahiwatig ni Tiny Deluxe.
Yeah. I think the look was the most basic out of everyone. Mm-hmm. I don't love the look. It's not really elevated. Mm-hmm. The hair was flat.
Sa ano niya, sa yun, di ba, pag kailangan natin mag-lip-sync doon sa performance natin, doon ako na kulangan din kay Tiny kasi yes, tumalikod siya habang nando pa yung ano niya, yung lyrics na
yes,
yung song. So dapat sana yung pagtalikod niya, sana quick turn na lang
yes,
yun.
But overall, I still think it's a great performance. Yeah? Great introduction to the mm-hmm, girls. Everyone had their time and everyone really presented really well. Yeah. I still think it's a good performance. Kahit i-compare mo yan sa ibang girl groups out there. Are you ready to see some world-class looks on the Mother Talking Runway today?
I'm excited. I'm so excited.
Yeah, so for the first ever runway of Drag Race Philippines Season 2, category is Feather You Like It or Not. Do you like it?
I like it.
Oh, you like it?
I like it.
You like it? First to step on the runway is Matilda.
Victoria's Secret vibes. Pero ang talino ni Matilda. Kasi sa lyrics ng ano niya, ng girl group, Matilda hindi maldita. Pero yung lumabas siya ng runway, parang, boom!
Kontrabida.
Versatile ang bakla.
Yeah, I have to agree with you on that one. I think most of the girls this episode brought a lot of variety when yes, it comes to looks and presenting who they are. I really love this look, Matilda. I think for me, it's the best look on the runway tonight. Up next is Captivating Kat Kat with another reveal.
Yeah?
She has a lot of reveal this episode.
Maganda. Yung colors ng ano yan, trans. Ayun, maganda. Naka-swimsuit. Dapat sana madami pang feathers.
Yes.
Yun eh. Kasi yung category is feather you like, ito na. Because this is Drag Race. Mm-hmm. Dapat exage lahat.
Yeah, I think the look is it's okay. I think it's pretty. It's pretty on her, just like what the judges says. But I think it's more of an entrance look than a runway look. You know what I mean? I wish, yeah, tama yung sabi mo, more feathers. If you're gonna be a swan, be a fucking swan, girl. Mm-hmm. But yeah, I love the meaning behind it. Up next on the runway is Tiny Deluxe serving you sabong realness. What do we think of the look?
Hindi ko nakita yung sabong kung hindi niya ginanon.
Yep.
Hindi ko maintindihan yung hat na may yes, sabong.
Yeah, I wish it could have been, you know, more clear. Tama yung sinabi ni BJ na hindi niya masyadong nag-gets kasi umpisa pa lang hinahawakan niya na and they don't know what the hell is happening. But overall, I think by the end of the presentation, nag-gets ko siya. So I was like, okay, this is a thinking queen. She thinks about her looks. Okay, up next is Nicole Pardo. What do we think of the look?
Nakulangan, sayang. Sayang. Yung sinabi niya na sinulog vibes. Mm-hmm. Yung parang colorful. Sana yung, kasi ang daming costumes sa Cebu na magaganda. Mm-hmm. One of the best costumes in the festivals of the Philippines is Sinulog Festival in Cebu.
All things considered, this is the best that she could put out. And I'm very happy na she took the chance to really still represent her hometown.
Cebu.
Up next on the runway is Arizona Brandy serving us Dream Catcher Fantasy. What do we think of the look?
I love the headdress. Yung alam mo kagad paglabas pa lang, Dream Catcher.
Yes.
Yung sa gown, the length of the gown.
The length of the gown is killing me. I can see the shoes. The shoes.
Alam mo yan yung hindi lang na ano na edit yung sa ano sa akin.
Yeah.
Yun din eh.
I remember.
Diba? Ang ganda na dito ni Morgana. However,
wala silang sinabing maganda.
Maganda na yung outfit. Okay, yung okay. Outfit, hindi yung mukha. Maganda ang buhok, maganda ang ano, ang Pilipinyana. Kaso lang,
bitin. But I must say that her concept is very clear. Nag-gets ko kaagad. I love it. It's still, at the end of the day, it's still a decent look. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, it's drag. Yeah, I
ganda.
Love it.
The face.
Perfect. And last but not least, we see Miss Jade So on the runway with this Ibong Adarna Couture. What do we think of the look?
Pinag-isipan.
Mm-hmm.
Pinag-isipan ang Filipino literature na Ibong Adarna. Aha. Tapos, yung, kasi si Jade So nilabas na lahat ng body niya from entrance to the confessional hanggang sa ano sa girl group. But this runway, tinakpan. Perfect.
Mm-hmm. I must say that, you know, sana yung pagka-rotate nung feathers could have still shown a little more shape.
Mm-hmm.
Para lang hindi siya malaking, okay, marami akong feathers dito.
Oo.
Alam mo yun? Like,
dapat sana pag...
May feathers currencies. Ayun dapat
yung ayun nilagay dapat yung ni Nicole Pardo.
Ni Nicole Pardo.
Dapat ito yung...
Feathers. Okay. Wish, make a wish. Paano?
Magpapalaki
ng titi?
Magpapalaki ko ng
titi. But speaking of malaking titi, Miss Jade Show still owned that runway. I really loved it. I think sa kanya yung pinaka, pag nakita mo, feather.
Mm.
Feather ito. Yung category ng runway. So,
that
I think
drag.
It's a very, very, very good, good first episode for Miss Jade. And Mama Pau revealed the winner.
Mm-hmm.
Arizona Brandy! Congratulations, Arizona!
Yes!
At dahil dyan, meron kang rubadge at 80,000 pesos.
Ayan. Congratulations.
Do you agree?
No.
For you, who should have won?
Sa akin, ha? Para sa akin, ha? Baka anuhin ko lang fans ni Arizona Brandy. Pero for me, it's Jade So.
Mm-hmm.
Yung ano yun, the running niya.
Yeah.
Pero kung binase sa performance ng girl group, it is Arizona Brandy.
Yeah.
But for the runway, it is Jade So.
But arguably, I think Arizona in total you know, I can see why the judges made her win. Everything combined, I think she really did well. Yep, I think she really deserved that. Also, Miss Jade could have easily won that as well. And then Mama Pau revealed that one of them is going home.
First episode pala, anim to eight. So yung eliminated, hindi makikita yung ano other
second
half.
Second half.
Wow, si Nicole.
Ano sabihin niya? Mamaya na. Kawawa naman yung ma-eliminate.
Kawawa naman yung ma-eliminate, bakla.
Okay, Mama Pau then revealed that Miss Jade So, Matilda, and Kat Kat are all safe for the week. Do you... have any... hindi ka pala safe. No, tatanungin sana kita kung anong feeling na maging safe sa first episode.
Hindi.
But then again, okay, I'm gonna ask you the real question that you can answer.
Eto na nga. Eto na nga.
Mama Pau then revealed that Nicole Pardo and Tiny Deluxe are both in the bottom. Do you have any... Sa tingin mo, ano yung nararamdaman ng girls ngayon?
Ay, yung feeling ko, ano daw, parang nangingiding na sila sa ano sa takot na... konting panahon lang ang binigay sa kanila ng exposure na tapos naging bottom pa, tapos ano na nga mag-lip-sync pa. Yung ano ko yung experience ko sa season 1 nung pagsabi na I'm part of bottom, kaming dalawa ni Prince na bottom, parang naiiyak ako, parang ayokong umuwi ng Davao na ganito lang.
Correct.
Oo, ang layo ng binyahe ko, tapos episode 1 lang ako. Mm-hmm. Hindi pwede to.
Correct. So, lalaban
tayo. Lalaban tayo. Te, ang tagal-tagal mo na nagda-drag. Ito na yung, ito yung pinakita mo, ipakita mo na sa judges na this is the 17 years of drag.
Yeah, that's what I love about the lip sync for your life format na talagang lalaban sila. Tiny Deluxe and Nicole Pardo are both in the bottom. I think it's the right decision of the judges to put them in the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
And also based on, I think the girls also felt that. Kasi nung tinanong sila ni Mama Pau, who should go home on the first episode?
Yun yung masakit.
Yun yung masakit.
Yun yung masakit na, salamat lang din na sa kami yung 12, hindi kami tinanong. Ganon. Oh. Ng first episode.
Oh, the first episode, grabe. Oh. First impression pa lang, tingin mo, papapauwiin ka na ng other girls.
Like, diba?
I get why Tiny Deluxe got a little bit emotional.
Pero
that's what they signed up for. It's a motherfucking TV. So they are asked to prepare for a lip sync of Fort Impact's song, Here We Go. Yeah. Do you know this song?
Here we go, can't hold you back anymore.
Iba yun!
Boogs. Up, girl, just let it from the head to the shoulders, knees and toes.
But looking at the girls at that very moment, sino sa tingin mo yung mag-excel?
Yung ano ko, sa akin na yung hindi pa natugtog yung music, confident ako kay Nicole nun.
Mm-hmm.
Feeling ko meron pa tuloy
right?
bubugan.
Iba yung tindig niya eh. At saka, lalo na when you're representing a whole province, di ba?
Mm-hmm.
You have that extra grit and power. As the lip sync goes along, who do you think is doing well?
Yeah, yung pag lip sync na nila, doon na yun, yung mata ko na kay ano na, kay Tiny Deluxe.
Doon na nagkatalo.
Ay!
Right away, boom!
Ganon. Tapos,
yung buka ng tiny, bunganga,
oh,
diba?
Buka ng bunganga, the yung, timing, yung hinga.
Mm-mm.
Doon yung ano yeah. Yeah, lip sync 101, learn your song.
Pwede akong isang close up.
Ganon.
Just learn your fucking song, girl. Okay.
Proceed.
Proceed.
May popcorn ba dyan?
Just me, you. Let's go.
Okay, proceed.
Yeah, going back to the lip sync, do you love na Tiny Deluxe made fun of her props?
Yun yung tinatawag natin na gulat factor.
At saka yung bilis ng pag-iisip, oo, yung wit on stage.
Pa, ganun. Kung anong, ano. Alam mo ba yung lip sync ko ng season 1?
Hindi ko alam.
Oh, yun, nag-lip sync for your last time. Maganda sana. Yung ina talaga.
Sorry, hindi ko kasi na-experience mag-lip sync for my life.
Oh? Oo nga, hindi siya lang. Lip sync for the crown lang pala siya nun.
Ayun, talo.
Ayun, di ba? Pero patas tayo, te.
Nakakainis!
Going back.
Okay. If you're a good lip syncer, you must be very aware of everything that's happening around you.
True.
Make sure that you make something out of something you see, something you hear, something you touch when you're on stage. And that is a mark of a good lip syncer. Mm-hmm. So, bravo to both of the girls for putting up a really, really entertaining first lip sync of the season.
Mm-hmm.
And then, Mama Pao then revealed that Tiny Deluxe was safe to slay another day.
Yay!
Do you agree?
I agree.
Yes, we do agree. Tiny Deluxe really owned that lip sync.
Mm-hmm.
And then, sad to say, Nicole Pardo was asked to sashay away. Do you have any message for Sashay Away?
For the Sashay Away awardee.
Yes, the first Sashay Away awardee is Nicole Pardo.
And of course, she is the newly elected president
of the welcoming committee
of season 2.
And speaking of president, no,
Ayan.
I would like to say, Nicole Pardo, the whole Cebu is very, very proud of you. Ano? Mm-hmm. Marami akong mga botante dyan. No?
Mm-hmm.
We're very, very proud of Nicole Pardo for really representing, kahit given the short amount of time, we were able to get to know her. The whole Cebu is proud of you. Well, that's it for us on the first episode of Drag Race Philippines Season 2. Thank you, Lady Morgana, for joining me here today. Where can we find you on social media, shows? Do you have anything to promote?
Yes, of course. Nandun din ako. Paikot-ikot ako ng bar lang. It's either Nectar, O-Bar. And of course, sa bagong bar ni Silhouette, abangan niyo po mga kaibigan. For the whole Wednesdays of August, ano ko sa Hosik. Speaking of August 16 po mga kaibigan with feelings sa aking first movie.
Yes!
As a supporting role na pinamagatang Third World Romance. Abangan nyo yan, mga kaibigan with feelings, as Lady Morgana enters the world of entertainment, the world of show business, and the world of
moving. God.
World of wonder.
Ganun. Yes! Where they can find you on social media.
You can add me on social media, Lady Morgana Paris on Facebook and Instagram and Twitter. It's Lady Morgana. And for my Grindr Top Guy 21, ayan. So, abangan nyo, mag-chat-chat tayo mga kabi. My profile pic po, nandun ako sa La Union. Charas! Ayan po, dalay gun.
But before I let you go, bilang nag-stopover ka na, kailangan meron kang pasalubong. Diba? Sa lahat ng stopover, nag-uuwi ng pasalubong lahat ng mga biyahero, biyaherista.
Sige.
Okay, halika dito. Halika.
Okay. Sorry kasi naka-ano ko, galing ako Cyprus.
Well, in true Filipino fashion, a stopover wouldn't be complete without pasalubongs.
Yay!
Yes! And they're all edible.
Mm, yeah.
So edible. Lady Morgana, please, grab something that really represents your experience here at the stopover.
Okay.
Go for it. Take anything you want.
Ito, hopya.
Hopya.
Mango. Ito.
Dried mangoes. Kasi dried din ang?
Dried yung performance ko. Dried yung performance ko dun sa pag-alimit. Pero, dried mangoes from Cebu, para maalala ko din si Nicole Pardo.
Yeah.
Pastel!
Ayan, o pastel.
Sweet.
Sweet. Oh well.
Sweet person.
Thank you so much for dropping by.
Thank you.
The stopover.
Mwah.
Mwah. Ingat.
Dalay gun.
Ingat. Well, that's it for us at your favorite quick stop on the way to the crown. I'm your Filipina diva, Marina Summers, and this has been The Stopover. Do you want unauthorized gay shit? Click subscribe to watch The Stopover.